Good morning, my ladies. How are you? Welcome to our Friday workout. Today, we're going to work on your whole entire body. Woo! We got some good music, too. So again, you can start with a little dance just to warm up that body. It's always fun to dance. So ladies, we're going to need our weights today for the workout. The bench or a chair, a pillow if available, a band if available, and a mat. Okay, so what we'll start with is sumo squats. I know you want to work the inner thighs. We've all been asking for inner thigh exercises. So we're going to do a couple different ones today. Now, if you do have sensitive knees, I will prefer that you can do the seated leg lifts, okay? So sitting on the chair. Now, you could do the weights, and you could use the weights just what I'm doing, same movement, but maybe just using a chair and doing leg lifts instead, okay? If you have sensitive knees. Now, what we'll do, ladies, we're going to go toes out. Make sure the knees feel good. You're pushing through your heels. You're lifting your toes up. You've got the body nice and tall. Now, I have 3-pound weights. I think that's perfect weight for the warm-up, especially if you have a sensitive shoulder. If you're doing any of the movements and you feel tension in the shoulder, I want you just to keep the weights on your thighs, okay, instead of moving the arm. So what we'll start with is a punch forward and a row. So see how I'm coming forward, punching forward with my thumb up. Then when I come in, I squeeze my shoulders together and I twist my palm up. So we go punch forward and squeeze the upper back, okay? So what we're doing is we're warming up your shoulders and upper back at the same time. So punch forward and row. Again, if there's any pressure in your shoulder, you just do the sumo squat. If the knee feels funny, you do the leg lift with a punch. Good job. Out and twist. If it feels funny on the wrist to twist, you just go. You could go back and forth like this without twisting the wrist. Nice.
Keep going. Exercise.
Nice. Let's make it a little more fun. So now we're going to keep the arm out, only if your neck allows you. And you're going to do little pulses and figure eight with your arm, okay? I want to kind of get the arm nice and tired. If you normally have tension in your neck, you're going to do a couple of these and you're going to bring it back, okay? Just to give your neck a little break. If your neck feels good, just keep going. Little pulses. Great exercise for the shoulders. Make sure the shoulder feels good. So figure eight with the arm on the level of the shoulder. See how my thumb is up. That's really important for the shoulder. See how I'm pulsing with my thighs. Woo! I'm getting my thighs. And I'm getting my arms and shoulders working right now. Ladies, I'm going to have to take my sweatshirt off. You're already getting warmed up. I'm getting warmed up already. Woo! Keep going.
Stop. Exercise.
Very nice. So I'm going to just take this off, ladies. We're going to switch sides. So again, you're going to do a punch. So you're punching forward. You're coming back, pinching the shoulder blades together, okay? And you're going to go really wide with your feet. It's better for the knees.
Begin.
Push through the heels. So you do punch. And then pinch your shoulder blades together. Good. And every time you punch forward, you want to make sure your shoulders don't come up, okay? You keep them relaxed. Good. The other weight can go on top of the thigh. Beautiful. Nice work. So sumo squats are one of my favorite exercises for the inner thighs. Beautiful. Because you can get your balance this way. You can get your thighs. You can get that core working. A little bit of everything. Your tushy's working as well. Pinch the shoulder blades together.
Exercise.
Good. So now we're going to do that figure eight with a little pause for the legs. The pulse is always harder. What happens when we pause, we keep the tension in the muscle. Especially for the second set, it's always harder. Good. Smiling.
Begin
Fridays. Oh, the weekend's almost here. Hopefully everybody's doing something fun and exciting. Keep going. Shoulders relaxed. Chest open. Good breathing. Good. After this, ladies, we're actually going to start with a regular plank. Now, I'm going to start on the bench, and then I'm going to make it harder and harder. Okay? If you have a sensitive back, do not do the movement. Just hold the plank. Keep going. Squeezing the abs super tight. We're almost there. I know you got it in you.
Stop exercise and switch.
Good one. That's awesome. So, now what we're going to do, we're going to go on your forearms here, elbow directly underneath the shoulder, You can do the forearms or straight arms, whatever feels better on your neck and shoulders. Squeeze your tushy super tight, okay?
Begin set one.
Knees are soft, so this is the modified version, just holding a plank. Now I'm gonna make this a little more challenging. I squeeze my tushy, then I drop my hip to the side, I bring it back. So you kind of tilt your hips to the side, but you wanna feel it along your side. You don't wanna feel this in your low back. So you go side, squeeze your tushy, okay? You kind of twist to the side, but you keep this squeeze the whole entire time. Side, squeeze your tushy super tight.
Stop.
Side again, squeeze it super tight. Now, again, if you need to modify it for your back or your shoulder, you can always go like this. Do it this way, just a little bit easier on the back and the shoulders. Good. Side, squeeze in the tushy. Last 2 sets, I'm going to show it to you.
Begin set two.
So again, we're going to go back on your forearms. Good. Little side. Squeeze your tushy. You want to make sure your back feels good. This is only if your back feels good. Woo! Keep going. Squeeze that tushy. Last 2 sets. I'm going to try to do this on the floor. It's going to be an extra challenge. Now, this is already hard for you, and you worry about your back. Stay on the bench or the chair or the bed. If you want to make it harder, just like me, good, let's go on the floor.
Stomach exercise.
Take a break, ladies. That's a good one. That's great. Make sure that shoulder feels good. Okay, so now I'm going to start with straight arms or forearms, whatever feels good for your shoulder and your elbows and your wrists. I'm going to actually do knuckles just to show you the form on this.
Begin set three.
So you go up like this. You drop your hip. You feel that side. You squeeze your tushy. Drop it. Good. Squeeze your tushy super tight. My goodness, this is a good one. Woo! We don't do this one as often. Squeeze that tushy super tight. Good. Down. I think I'm going to have you start doing it more and more because I really feel my obliques. Woo! Side. Squeeze that tushy. Good. Make sure that back feels good. Almost there. Again, you have your straight arms, forearms. Woo!
Exercise.
Nice work. Good job, ladies. We got one more. I'm going to do it on my forearms. I'm definitely going to be out of breath. You'll see. And then after this, we'll do leg lifts. Either I'm going to do them on the floor, but if you have a sensitive back, you're going to do it on the chair with the weight. Okay, we're going to use the weight today for your leg lift.
Begin set.
Okay, so now we're on our forearms. Abs are super tight. Again, first thing, you squeeze your tushy. You drop it to the side. You squeeze it again. Drop it to the side. Squeeze that tushy super tight. Good go. Abs are engaged the whole time. You don't want to feel that back. Woo! Keep going. Nice. Almost there. Seconds left. If it gets too much, just do straight arms. Keep going. Woo! This is the hardest thing ever, ladies.
Stop exercising.
Nice work.
To the next.
Good job. Hopefully everybody learned that. Good work. Good work, everybody. Okay, so now, again, you should have felt the shoulders and the core and the sides. So now, ladies, let's have some more fun with some weights. So what we're going to do, I'm going to put a weight right here.
Abs
are engaged. We're going to point your toes up. You're going to lift, hold it for 10, and then lower all the way, only if you have to. If you don't have to, lower halfway. Let's squeeze it. You can use a 3, 5 pound. If you feel like your legs are really, really strong, use a 7, 10 pounds, as long as your back feels good. Nice. So see how I'm tucking this knee in to protect my back? And you could always do it on the chair if you need a little break for your back, okay? Nice. You could just do little pulses if you want to make it harder. But with the weight,
stop.
It can get a little bit more challenging on your back, so be careful. Beautiful. Nice work. Very good. I know your body's saying, let's switch. But if everything feels good, stay on the same side. Good. Keep breathing.
Begin set two.
Good job, ladies. Nice. Shoulders relaxed. Very good. I know you miss those leg lifts. They're one of the best exercises for your quads. Also, if you have sensitive knees, you should be doing those almost every day if you can. So get your hip flexor. Get your quads. And it really doesn't put any pressure on your ankle or your knee. So it's a really good exercise. The extra weight definitely makes it harder. Be careful on that low back. He wants to take over on this if the hips kind of rotate. Don't let him.
Exercise.
Nice. Take a break. Let's switch sides. Again, shoulders are down the whole time. Chest stays open and we're breathing. Don't forget about breathing. Breathing is very important. So when you go up with a leg, exhale through the mouth, okay? Shoulders down again.
Begins at three.
Remember, when it gets really, really hard, we have a tendency of shrugging the shoulders because our body thinks it's helping, but it's not. It's going to bring tension in your neck, which is, that's not what we want. We want to keep the shoulders relaxed, feeling that planning between the shoulder blades. Remember that game we play sometimes when I have you squeeze the penny? Let's play that game today. Everybody, squeeze the penny in between your shoulder blades. Find that penny there. Good. Promise you're going to be sore from this. Good. We didn't do leg lifts last time.
Stop.
So I know some of you missed it. The Polish chair ladies. Beautiful. I think it's Carolyn's favorite exercise. Good job. Shoulders relaxed. Chest open. I hope it's everybody's favorite.
Begin set four.
It's such a hard exercise. It looks so simple. Keep going. So after this, ladies, let's grab weights and let's do presses. So we're going to grab, if you have a sensitive shoulder, like a 3 and 5. If your shoulders are good, go heavier, okay? We're going to be pressing very narrow next to the body. Now, this is exercise that can tweak your shoulder if you don't do it right. So I'm going to show you the right form, then I'm going to make it harder and harder with every set, okay? Keep going.
Stop exercise. Woo! Switch to the next.
Very good. So I'm grabbing 5. I've got 5 available. And what we're going to do, I'm going to show you the modification. Again, arms are nice and straight, shoulders down. If you have a sensitive shoulder, don't move the arms. Just keep them there. If your shoulders are good, you're going to tuck them next to the body. But don't let your elbow touch the floor. And then
begin
come up.
Set one.
Okay. This is if you have okay shoulders and a sensitive back. If your back is pretty good, sometimes twingy, but not too bad, you can lift your legs up and then do this. Okay, I'm going to make this harder, do not worry. As you're holding your legs up, you have to make sure your back stays flat. The more this is happening, the more we forget about our stomach and how to engage the core. So every time you go up with your arms, you exhale through the mouth and you squeeze the abs. So I want you to imagine I put something underneath your back, like a piece of paper, and I want to slide it in between one side to the other. You say no to that. So now, ladies, let's make this harder. So every time I press up, I lift my hips up. That's only if you have a good back. If you have a sensitive back, don't do this exercise, ladies.
Back two.
So you go down, not all the way. You come up, and then you lift. Now, when you lift, it's the abs doing the work, okay? Nothing else, just the low abs. And you don't feel any twinges in your back. The whole time you're squeezing the abs super tight. And again, I want to challenge you with different things, ladies, but I definitely want to keep you safe with your back, okay? So be careful. Now again, when there's a lot going on, we forget about the form, so let's remind you the form again. So elbows close to the body. You can always go heavier on the weights if you have good shoulders, ladies, but always make sure that the elbows are close to the body like this, okay? And then you come up. And you go. Okay, so I'm going to make this a little bit more challenging now. Now, this is if your back is really, really good. Now, this is really hard. So go up and then lift. See how my legs are a little bit straighter. For some of you, this might be bothering your back. So go back to feet down. Or one leg up. Change it up a little bit. Good. I'm going to make this a little bit more challenging in a second, ladies, for the final set. You know, I always want to challenge you. I always will combine exercises because it's better for you. Because you're working more muscles all at once. Woo! Keep going. Nice. So So now for the final one, I'm going to drop my leg a little bit, bring it back, lift. I'm going to keep my arms up. I'm going to drop that leg a little bit, bring it back up. This is only if you have a good back, okay? If your back is sensitive, don't do this. If you want to
begin set four.
Last challenge, you bend the knees, extend, bring it in. Extend the legs, bring it in, up. The idea, the most important thing about this exercise, ladies, is to not let your back come off, okay? Once it comes off, it won't be good. That can twinge your back, your low back, ladies. Shoulders relax. Good. Keep going. I know you got it in you. Then after this, ladies, we are going to do bridges. Who loves bridges?
Scalp exercise.
Take a break, ladies. There we go. Actually, you know what? I changed my mind. Let's do scalp crushers first. So, because we have the weights already, so we might as well use them right now, okay? So what we're gonna do for this exercise, ladies, we're gonna start with a skull crusher. Remember, our skull crushers are a fun exercise where you keep your arms together, you've got your elbow directly underneath your shoulder, and you lift, okay? So we go down slowly. Again, this is just the modification for everybody. Shoulders are down, don't look too heavy unless you have good elbows and good shoulder, you can go heavy. Now you're just having fun, you're keeping your abs super, super tight, okay? Now to make this a little bit more challenging, again, you can bring your legs up like this, keeping the abs in, squeezing the abs super tight. So I always give you modification. Beautiful, and then always make it harder too. Good, so this is now, we're going up and down, up and back, five. Beautiful, I'm gonna make this harder, okay? I'm gonna challenge your coordination right now. So you're gonna go down, you're gonna come up, you're gonna cross your legs. Good, go down, squeeze the abs, cross the legs. Good, go down slowly, come up, cross the legs. Now let's talk about the low back right now, ladies. Squeeze the abs so hard like you're doing a crunch, okay? You don't wanna feel that low back. I never want you to feel a twinge there, ladies. Beautiful, down, abs are in, good. Cross the legs, beautiful. Good breathing. Woo. Now after set two, I'm gonna put a band over my feet to make this harder. Exhale fully, keep your back flat. So I'm gonna grab a quick band if you have available or not, just keep going with what I'm doing.
Exercise.
Take a break, ladies. So I'm gonna put my band just to make it more fun. You could do over your, let's start with the ankles first. Now make sure that back feels good. If your back is not feeling good, keep your both feet down. Or just lift them up a little bit, then knees.
Begin
then knees are always
three.
On your back, okay? I'm gonna go with the legs straight. My back feels pretty good today. So I'm gonna go down, tricep, open. Good, so again, I'm using fives on this. If I had heavier weights, I could probably go up to eight on that one. My back is nice and flat, my abs, and the abs are engaged. I'm not arching my back at all. Once I start doing that, it's really gonna put a lot of pressure on my low back, ladies. Good, keep going. Nice. Sometimes when you see me crunching and keeping my legs straight, that's really because you're on your back.
Exercise.
Here you have to work a little harder. Now I'm gonna switch the band over my feet to make it even more challenging. I know you always want that extra challenge. Inhale, exhale. Good, very good. Inhale, exhale.
Begin set four.
Keep going. Make sure this feels good on your back. No pain in your back right now. Good. You got the hips going. You got the arms going. We're doing a little combo. Those are the most fun. Now, after this, we have a bridge going, okay? And a fly. So, if you have a sensitive shoulder, use a 3-pounder. Or maybe no weighty, even if you worry about your shoulders. If your shoulder feels pretty good today, you can do a 5, a 7. We have to really be careful with that form, okay? Now our band will stay on and it's gonna go over the top of the thighs.
Woo! Stop exercise.
Nice work, ladies. Let's get down.
Station.
So we only have 10 minutes left, so I wanna make sure. So 3 more exercises left. I wanna make sure we push really hard today. So what we're gonna do, ladies, I'm gonna keep one weight, okay? One weight, the band is over the top of the thighs if you have available. So we're gonna start with the bridge first, okay? So
begin set.
If your back is sensitive, you just go up and down. If your back is okay, you lift your hips up, you keep the tension on the band, and you're gonna extend your arm a little bit. See how I'm not going all the way down? I'm not feeling this in my shoulder, I'm not feeling this in my back, okay? I'm squeezing my tushy. It's an isometric, it's a stability exercise. I know you like to work the balance. Now this is too easy for me. So I'm gonna extend my leg out. So I'm pushing through that heel of the standing leg. Now let's think about the arm. The arm is not going far out, ladies. So if you go really, really far with a heavy weight, this is where shoulder injuries happen. Good. I want you to go down, but don't touch the the elbow all the way, okay? That might be too much for that shoulder again. So again, I'm staying on the same side,
but
you're challenging, and I'm extending that arm, and I bring it back. Squeeze that tissue. Beautiful. If you want your back to work a little less, you lift that leg a little higher. Beautiful. Squeeze in the abs. I know we've done a lot of core, so the back might be getting tired. Beautiful. Out, and in. Squeeze in the abs. So again, see how this weight is pulling me this side, this leg is going that way. So it's a coordination and stability exercise. Woo, keep going. I'm burning my tissue already. You don't have to go high on this. Again, if that's too much for the back, you both feet down.
Stop. Exercise.
Take the brake legs. And you don't have to go extremely heavy on the shoulder. It's more of a coordination stability exercise. On stability work, you don't want to go too heavy because it's really easy to twinge your back when you do stability and heavy weights. So now we're going to squeeze the abs. Squeeze your tissue.
Three.
We extend it out and we bring it in. Now, our tissue, let's talk about our tissue right now. It's on fire. Okay, you're squeezing it so hard. So again, this is a modification. You need to go up and down with the hips if you're worried about your back. Or you can keep your hips down and just move the arm if you need to make it a little easier. That might be too easy for some of you, but however you're feeling today, keep that back safe, okay? Beautiful. The key of the workout is to get the body stronger, not to hurt it. So whenever you feel any kind of discomfort anywhere, let me know. Good, I'm gonna just readjust my foot and I'm coming up again. Good job. Squeeze in the abs, ladies. Good. So after this, we're gonna do squats. I'm gonna show you the proper way of squatting with the band. I'm gonna put my bands below my knees, okay? Beautiful. Shoulders relaxed, chest open. Keep going. I know you got this in you. Watch that shoulder, don't go too low. Again, those flies are challenging for the shoulders. Try to keep those hips nice and aligned. Then after this, the band goes over the top of my, below my knee, okay? If you have one available, if you have sensitive knees and you worry about squats, do a wall sit or a leg lift. Now, when you do that leg lift today, if you have a band, just go to the side with the leg so it's something different than the leg lifts we've done before. Woo! Keep going! Come on!
Stop exercising. Yeah,
felt that burn. Okay, so today I'm actually saving the side plank at the end. Ooh, it's gonna be super fun. Surprise, surprise, ladies. Coming your way. So, let's say you have a chair available and you wanna sit on that chair. You've got the band below the knees, okay? You're pushing your knees out. First set is in just the proper form. So, see how I'm hinging up my hips? I'm sticking my butt out as far as I can. I'm on my heels. And then come up, squeeze your tissue, okay? So let's top four. Knees go out, hips go back, I feel the quads, my glutes, I come up, squeeze my tissue. And you're gonna say, Evie, that's too easy. It's okay, we'll make this harder, don't worry. Let's go 10 pulses, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then come up, squeeze your tissue. You don't wanna feel twitches in your knees. If you do, you just seat it, leg lifts to the side, okay? Now again, we're all sitting in a chair, we're all going to the bathroom, we're all sitting in the car. So we squat so many times that we do it daily.
Set two.
We just want to make sure we do it that right way. So knees push out, squeeze that tissue. Now let's stay lower and longer. So now shoulders are down, pushing through the heels. If the knees feel good, you just stay low, don't come up. Push through that heel. Knees are pushing out because the band's going to let your knees come in. Don't do that, ladies. Don't let it. Keep going. Nice. Pushing through those heels. Good. I want you to feel those quads, glutes, not your low back. If you feel your low back, come on up, squeeze the tissue. Keep going. Again, if that's too much for your knees, you're going to sit on the bench.
Stop.
You're going to keep your band, and you're going to move your leg to the side. You stay on the same leg for 2 sets to make it harder. Let's keep going. Good. Abs are tight. We're going to come up through the break, and I'm just going to do a couple calf raises to give your knees a little break. Work that balance, and then we're back for the next two.
Begin set three.
We're not going to stop. We're just pulsing. Good. Squeezing the abs. Shoulders down. So, while we finish with this exercise, ladies, we're going to do side planks. Again, if you can't do side planks, you do regular planks. Today, we're going to do the side planks with a ball. You can use your pillow. And we're gonna drop, we're gonna squeeze the inner thighs and you're gonna drop your hips. So you're gonna do two things, inner thighs and sides, okay? I'll show you. Keep going. Abs are super tight. Good. See how I'm massaging my legs? That's where the burn is. But I'm pushing the knees out. If you ever want to make sure that your knees are safe, you can even put your hands there and kind of push the arms out a little bit. Good. Little pulses. Then everybody should be burning by now. If you're not, let me know. It's a great skiing exercise. Now my back is nice and flat. Come on up, speed.
Begin set four.
Last set. Little pulses. Good. We're skiing down the mountain. We can't stop, ladies. Good. I know we've done some leg work, so the legs are pretty tight right now. Again, pushing the knees out, staying on my heels. Now you got this. Come on. Keep going. See how my back is flat? I'm not rounding my back. That will put a lot of pressure in my low back. So ladies, after this, we're going to grab a pillow. We're going to go on your side. If you have a good shoulder, we're going to take this band off, okay? We're almost done with the band. Woo! Keep going. Don't give up over here.
Stop exercise.
Three, two, one. Okay, great. You're going to be so sore in your thighs. You'll see. Okay, so now, ladies, we're getting rid of the band. We got our pillow or a ball, whatever you have available. And we're going into the side plank. If you're doing a regular plank, you could put a pillow in between your inner thighs as well and just squeeze your tissue super tight.
Begin set.
So, ladies, I'm going to do the modification first. The ball squeeze, elbow directly underneath the shoulder. I'm going up, squeezing the ball. So, I'm actually bending both knees. Squeezing the ball and going up and down with my hips. For a lot of you, this is too easy. If it is, keep both legs straight and then go up and down, okay? Good. Again, always a modification. I never will start without a modification because some of you might need it. And then if you start with a hard exercise and you have a bad shoulder or back, that will twinge it, right?
Come on.
So always start with a modification. I want you to feel your inner thighs twitching and the whole side. Now let's switch sides. The last two, I'm gonna make it with both legs straight, okay? And again, if you feel like this is too easy, just do both legs straight from the beginning, okay?
Begin.
I'm gonna rest underneath the shoulder. I never want you to feel like it's too easy. Remember, 1 to 10, we wanna be in 10. I know I can't check on you right now because I'm not with you, but imagine I'm with you and I'm watching you the whole time. Good, you know my eyes are everywhere. Squeeze that tissue, squeeze the inner thighs, shoulders down, chest stays open. Good. Very good. Good breathing too. Inhale through the nose, exhale through the mouth. Good, never enough planks. Remember how much I love planks? I will make you do planks over and over, different variation, just to strengthen your body. So we will have to combine so many different exercises to work these muscle groups. But with plank, we do one exercise, and we're getting so many things. Your whole body's working right now. Almost wish you could check how many calories you burn on those planks.
Begin set three.
Good. Nice. So now you squeeze in the ball, your legs are straight, you're going up and down. So you've got inner thighs, you got your sides, you got your shoulders, you got your balance, stability, core, everything. Keep going. And you're smiling because it's Friday. And you're having fun, and you're almost done with your awesome workout. Keep going, ladies. Good. Don't forget to stretch, and I'm going to actually give you a little routine. I was thinking about different stretches for you. And keep going. Almost there. Woo! That was hard. Good one. Again, elbow directly under the shoulder. I'm going to actually give you a little routine to do in bed, okay? When you get out of bed in the morning or before you go to bed. Either one is good, but I'm going to give you a couple different exercises, stretches to do in bed, okay?
Begin set four.
Ready? Set, go. Elbow directly underneath the shoulder. Lift and squeeze. Squeeze that tissue super, super tight. Good. Inner thighs are working. If it's too much going up and down, just hold it. That's too much. Just bend both knees, but never give up. Beautiful. Keep going. Remember, to strengthen the body, you need to push through that burn. When you feel like you can't go anymore, give me a couple more seconds. As long as the form is good. Keep going. Keep breathing. Squeeze everything in the body.
Stop exercising. Your training is on the area.
That was super fun. So now, I'm going to give you a couple stretches we could do when we, before we go to bed or before we get out of bed, okay? So, let's say we're getting up in the morning, or let's say we're going to bed and kind of feel tired and tight. So let's start with a little pelvic tilt. You're going to squeeze the abs and slow release. You flatten your back, squeeze on the tushy, exhale through the mouth, and release. So again, you could do this before you even start your day, okay? Or you could do this at the end of the day. But this is, you could do this in bed, okay? Always good to have something before we start the day, especially if you have a sensitive back and you want to kind of start the day right, squeeze. Good. So number one, pelvic tilt. Number two, hugging that knee. So I'm gonna give you a little routine step by step so you can do it on your own. So we're gonna go, knee comes to you, shoulders relax. Hold that stretch. I'm not gonna hold it for the whole minute, but if you can hold it for about 45 to a minute, that's ideal. So you hold that knee in, now you cross that knee over to that opposite shoulder. So this is the third stretch, okay? You can feel a little stretch right here. So this is for whoever's got a sensitive back. I'm giving you that little routine because those are very easy on the back stretches. Good. Now let's switch sides. You're gonna go underneath that knee. Good, bring it to you, relax your shoulders. Make sure you're not tensing up the neck. Abs are super, super tight. You hold it in and then you cross it over again. Beautiful. Good, you feel that little stretch. Good, whenever you lift both legs up, you know that piriformis stretch with both legs up, it's a little hard on your back, so be very careful. Again, everybody with a sensitive back, this is perfect for you. It's just a little routine to get the day started. Beautiful. Then, so that was number three stretch. Then we have both the knees. Good. But squeeze the abs, relax your shoulders, you're hugging both knees now. Good. Very good. So this is our fourth stretch. And then slowly just open up the inner thighs. This is our first, fifth stretch. So you got five stretches, ladies, before you get out of bed or before you go to bed. Okay? You can do it in bed. That's the best. That's the best way. You can do it every day to get your day started. It's going to loosen things up. It's going to get the blood flow going. So you can do it all on your bed, on your back. Okay, now let's say we are in bed right now and we want to get out of bed. We always roll to the side like this. We put our hand down and then we come up, okay? So we want to avoid doing this. See how I'm coming up like that? Ooh, I can tweak my back very easily this way. Because to come up and do a sit-up, you have to engage your muscles properly. So you have to squeeze the abs and then slowly roll up. But we never do that, right? We just come up fast and then the back can get twingy. So you roll to the side, you go to the end of the bed, and then you come up. There you go. So these are your five stretches, ladies, that you can just do before you even get out of bed. That's the best part. So you start your day really, really fun, and your body's going to feel amazing. Now, ladies, don't forget to do more stretches on your own, and then your cardio. Always do your cardio. You do the weight training and then the cardio after, okay? That's going to help you burn more calories. It's going to help you with your cardiovascular fitness, and it's as important as the weight training. So make sure you do it, okay? Love you. Miss you. Good work.